inheritance. Define inheritance. Define inheritance. The properties of deriving a new class from existing class, we are going to call as a inheritance. Which means, already the default one class is present, we are going to inherit some properties from derived new class. We are going to derive a new property from the existing class, we are going to call as a inheritance. This inheritance is even one of the main important features of bookstores. So define inheritance. The properties of inheriting the some properties from parent class to child class, we are going to call as a inheritance. So there are different types of inheritance are available for us. What are they? Do you have any idea? So first one is called as a single inheritance. First one is called as a single inheritance. And the second one is called as a multiple inheritance. Then third one is multi-level inheritance. Then fourth one is called as a hybrid inheritance. Then fifth one is hierarchical inheritance. This is the five types of inheritance that books support for us. What's the single inheritance? Suppose if you use one parent class and one derived class, we are going to call as a single inheritance. So in this concept, we have only one base class, which means base class and one derived class. We are going to call as a single inheritance. One base class and one derived class we have. They are going to call as a single inheritance. Which means they are going to give one class and we are going to derive some properties from the parent class. Only once we are going to call as a single inheritance. One base class and one derived class. They are going to call as a single inheritance. Define base class. Means the properties that already present we are going to call as a base class. We are going to derive some properties from parent class to child class. We are going to call as a derived class. Do you have any doubt in this one? Anybody? Clear now? So if it is a single inheritance, then we are going to use one base class as well as one derived class. We are going to call as a single inheritance. Do you have any doubt in this one? So one base class, one derived class. We are going to call as a single inheritance. So the diagram is, see, this is a base class. We are going to call as a base class. We are going to derive some property to the child class. Called as a derived class. So hereafter, if I tell you the base class, then it is called as a parent class. If I tell you the derived class, then you need to know that it is a subclass. It means that the parent class is said to be a base class. The subchild class we are going to call as a derived class. We are going to inherit some property from parent to child. We are going to call as a inheritance. At the same time, if you use one base class and one derived class, then we are going to call as a single inheritance. Do you have any doubt in the single inheritance part? This is a definition for single inheritance. Next one, multiple inheritance. When we have base class as well as derived class. If it is a multiple inheritance, then you need to use two base class, we are going to derive the new class. So some property from the base class 1, some other property from the base class 2, we are going to derive the new class called as a derived. here more than one class, we are going to inherit some property to the derived class, we are going to call as on multiple inheritance. Clear or what? Any doubt in this one? Anybody? So now my question is, how can you declare this inheritance? How can you declare the inheritance? What is the general syntax of declaring the inheritance? Anybody? How can you declare the class?
Class name.
And then next one, class last name. Then access specifier. You need to declare as an access specifier. It may be a public, private, or it may be a protected. Anyone you can able to declare. Then you are going to declare the number variable. Number function. Then you are going to close the class with the help of bracket as well as semicolon. Now this is called a base class for you. Always the class as well as class name is come. You are going to call as a base class. Clear? Now I am going to give you the derived class. How can you give the derived class? Clear? So listen here, for class, derived class name, with class, derived class name, with derived class, class, derived class, colon, then access specifier, then, this base class name, this is called here, base class, so that, base class name. Clear? Then as usual, access specifier, then number variable, then number, then close the class, then semicolon. Then so now, we are going to call us a derived class. How can you tell that this is a derived class? Means, whenever if the class that comes with the colon, we are going to call us a derived class. Clear up? Clear? So, the class, derived class, as well as the colon, and then access specifier, base class name. Therefore, this access specifier will be a three types. What are they? Public, private, protected. You can able to declare anyone from this three. Access specifier. By default, your class is called as a private. We need to make the class as a public. Defaultly, the group supports as a private class for us, privately. All the variables as well as functions we are declaring inside the class as well as automatic program, all the things are safety are private. But we are going to make the variables as well as functions as a public. Yep. So this is the general syntax for the simple inheritance. As means ordinary inheritance concept. Yep. So the inheritance, if it is an inheritance, it consists of one class as well as another base. The one class is called as a base class and another one is called as a derived class. You need to. So this is the way you need to declare the inheritance concept. So depends upon this following heading, all the general syntax we are going to alter according to the following inheritance methodologies. Do you have any doubt in this one? Any doubt for? Clear no? Clear any doubt? Next one. See that this is the gender syntax for single inheritance. Clear? Next one. Multiple inheritance, I hope that you are going to derive one base class. Clear? Another one base class. Clear? And then you are going to derive the new property from this two base class. Which means more than one base class we are going to derive some property, means we are going to call as a multiple inheritance. Do you have any doubt on this multiple inheritance? Anybody? Anybody? Anyone? Clear? No? Now, next one is called as a multi-level inheritance. Multi-level inheritance. Yeah? Which means the derived class is going to act as a base class for us. The derived class is going to act as a base class for us. Listen, this is the base class and this is the derived class. Clear? So, base class and this is the derived class. Now, we are going to inherit the next class. Now, this class is going to act as a base class for this derived class. Clear? Now, this class is going to act as a base class for this derived class. If you give another one class, now this derived class is going to act as a base class for this derived class. We are going to call as a multi-level inheritance. The class that above the particular class, we are going to call as a base class, and another one is called as a derived class. We are going to call as a multi-level inheritance. Do you have any doubt in this one? Anybody? Next one is called as a hybrid inheritance. What's my hybrid inheritance? What's my hybrid? What's my hybrid one? We are going to combine any two inheritance methodology. It may be a single inheritance with multiple or multiple with multi-level. If you combine any two different inheritance, then we are going to call as a hybrid inheritance. It means you need to combine any one among this five inheritance techniques. Combine any two, then we are going to call as a hybrid inheritance. Clear? Do you have any doubt in this one? Clear? No? Next one is called as a hierarchical inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance. Any idea? Do you have any idea about this hierarchical inheritance? Anybody? Anybody? Hierarchical? So in the hierarchical, one class is going to act as a base class for several derived class. Several derived class. Clear? One base class. This is the base class. This is the base class. One base class. Several derived class. D1, D2, as well as D3. We are going to call as a derived class. Clear? So one base class, several derived class are there. Then we are going to call as a hierarchical inheritance. See the difference? If it is a single inheritance, then one class, one base class, one derived class. If it is a multiple inheritance, two base class means more than one base class, then going to derive some property to the new class. Instead of base class 1, base class 2, then derived class. Clear? So we are going to call as a multiple inheritance. Then if it is a multi-level inheritance, the above mentioned class is going to act as a base class for the derived class. In this diagram, this is called a base class and this is the derived class. The next time if you try to inherit some property from this to next class, now this derived class is going to act as a base class for us. This is not derived class. Again, if you try to inherit some property from this class, then this same derived class is going to act as a parent class for us. Likewise, vice versa, it is going on. We are going to call as a multi-level inheritance. If you combine any two inheritance methods, then we are going to call as a hybrid. Then what's my hierarchical means? What's my hierarchical? Any idea? One base class, several derived class. Means we are going to derive the property from one base class to many derived class. We are going to call as a hierarchical inheritance. Okay, do you have any doubt in this concept? Anybody? Anybody? Anybody?